Objection, the attorney yells over and over again. You're sitting in the back of the courtroom wondering, why is this attorney trying to prevent the jury from hearing this information? You want to know what this is all about? Come join me on this walk through the neighborhood as I tell you exactly what it's about. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. All right, you brought a lawsuit claiming that your doctor was careless, causing you significant harm and injury. And now your case goes all the way to trial. At trial, the defense lawyer gets up over and over and over again and objects while your attorney is asking your expert questions. And you're thinking, why is he doing this? How can he do this? Why doesn't he just let the attorney ask the question and let the jury hear the answer? Well, I'll tell you something. There are many different reasons why an attorney would raise an objection. He may think that the question is not asked properly. He may think that it's an inappropriate topic. He may think that the evidence upon which this expert is testifying may not be admissible. There could be many different legal reasons why an attorney would make such an objection. But now, here's the question. If an attorney makes one objection after the next, it looks like he's a yo-yo, right? Because he has to stand up every single time and yell out, "Objection, judge!" And now the judge has to make a ruling as to whether or not he agrees or disagrees with this particular attorney. If he agrees, that means now the attorney who's asking the question has to now ask a different question. So, let's go back to the question I raised at the beginning. If an attorney is making one objection after the next, is he trying to hide something from the jury? The answer might be yes. He may not want the witness to talk about something. He may think it's extremely damaging if the witness gives testimony about this particular topic. On the other hand, he may be doing it to preserve his client's right, and now he has an obligation to go ahead and make those specific objections in order to preserve his right should the judge rule against him, and now he loses the case. Now he may have to appeal that particular issue. So he may be doing it simply to preserve his client's right, knowing full well that the judge will allow this witness to go ahead and answer the question. On the other hand, there are some instances where an attorney, for strategic reasons, will make a decision to try and throw off the attorney's mind, throw off his mindset and what he's thinking about, by repeatedly objecting over and over again. But you, as a person sitting in the back of the courtroom watching these proceedings, may think, wait a second, he's trying to prevent this witness from saying something. The answer is, that may be one element of what he's doing, and that's a particular objective that the attorney may have when making these repeated objections. So why do I share this quick information with you? I share it with you because this comes up over and over again in every single case, whether it's a medical malpractice case or a wrongful death case or even an accident case that goes to trial. And now, during the course of trial, one attorney is objecting over and over and over again. And you're trying to figure out, why is he doing this? This gives you a little bit of an insight into what really goes on in these types of cases. You know, I realize you're likely watching this because you have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter did happen here in New York and you're thinking about bringing a lawsuit but haven't done so yet because you still have questions that need to be answered, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Gerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at oginski-law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Gerry Oginski. Have a great day.